international media. You saw Washington Post and the New York Times. Before the action happened, the story was written already. Al Jazeera, tweeting by ambassadors, which is unconventional. They were, even within the Caribbean region, the people who had some kind of vested interests. I'm asking, but do they have homes in Dominica? I was trying to find all these people who had all these vested interests. Do they own properties in Dominica? Do they create jobs in Dominica? And a lot of these people who were involved, we went to two disasters. And these people who were showing interest, I'm not in the business of naming names because they want to know themselves. They never helped us. They never gave us any help. And they're in a position to give lots of help. But they're the ones who had the greatest interest in seeing my back for their own narrow view about this. People have an issue about our demonstration of our independence. We're not reckless, but we're independent people. And there's a huge interest. I don't have the time to go on social media. Most people do, but the reports that my people were giving to me, I'm a Christian man. I'm not a religious person, but. Who am I not to be attacked? And Christ came on earth and he was a perfect being. And who is this little guy from a small island not to be persecuted relentlessly and with mistruths, untruths, misinformation, fake news, malicious stuff? I mean, if you want to attack me, attack me with the truth. But as I said, people are not going to know who Roosevelt Skerrit is. And they have sent a message not only to the opposition there, but all of the forces external to Dominica, that they are standing with Roosevelt Skerrit for an unprecedented fourth term as Prime Minister and fifth term for my party as a government Dominica. And the young people ran this campaign. My national campaign team, 98% of them were young people, below the age of 32. And in every constituency, the young people ran the campaign. In my own constituency, I never went there for the entire campaign period except yesterday. And my team there ran the campaign. One constituency that we have never won, for example, Roosevelt Central. My party never won Roosevelt Central, ever. And we had a comfortable win there. People had their voice, and people send their voice out. But we're not surprised by the extent of this. I'm hoping now that it can translate all this interest into contributions to our country's development. So I'm hoping that they could write to me and say, look, we supported the wrong horse in the race. You have not won and so on, so we'd like to work with you. But a lot of it has to do with opposition relations to things, well, nationally. But our view is that there were free and fair elections in Venezuela, and those who wanted to participated. And that recognize the government of President Nicolas Maduro, like we do everywhere else. We really love people. Once it is according to the constitution of this country, who am I to question it? I'll be interfering. It's to be accepted, so why she won. Congratulations to her. I really like to see her in the cabinet. I can only talk about the cabinet after I have advised His Excellency the President on who will be in the cabinet. I need to get sworn in first for me to trigger my authorities in the constitution. I believe section 69 is really what it
When does that happen, Kyle? You're swearing?
I'll be sworn in this afternoon at 3 p.m. Okay. Yeah.
And when will you need to get
there? Immediately thereafter. But I'm not in a position now to indicate who will be president, who will be the cabinet minister. Just to say that it's an exceptional personal sacrifice.